Hey, everybody. I had a question come in about automations if you are selling more than one thing. So we've all experienced that where we've purchased something and then you get that upsell, that one-time special offer. And so somebody was asking me, how do you automate this whole process and how do you send the email to deliver it and all of that kind of stuff? So I wanted to walk you through, it's kind of a two-part video here, how I first kind of map out my back-end automations, because here's the deal. If you don't build in some of these systems into your business, if you're manually doing all of this, there's no way that you can scale. So you always need to look for those systems so that you can basically just turn it on and it will run for you. Now, the software that I'm going to be demonstrating is on Gohighlevel. Sometimes you might have heard people refer to Funnel Gorgeous, FGF, or there's other white labeled programs out there. But Gohighlevel is, or Highlevel, however you want to say it, is an all-in-one marketing program. So that's what I'm going to demonstrate today. Now, keep in mind, there's some other programs that I love, like Kartra. It also does something very similar. The buttons look different and all of that. But the bottom line is you first need to start with a piece of paper and just kind of map out what you're trying to do. And that's what I've done here. So let me just talk about this for a minute. So basically, somebody comes into your world and they make a purchase. Now, there is a difference between a bump offer and a one-time special offer. I'm not going to go into that right now. But for this example, both of these are upsells. So what that means is you purchased it, and then on the thank you page, it's giving you the opportunity to purchase a special one-time offer. Now, what this one person wanted to do that asked me the question, they said, I want to deliver everything in one email. So, you know, if they purchase three things, you could send out just three automatic emails, but they were all PDFs or something like a Canva template, something like that. They wanted to deliver everything at once. So, over here on the left, this would be the flow. Somebody comes into the world, they purchase, okay? Then on that thank you page, they are given the opportunity for a special one-time offer. They purchase that. They go on to the next, which is the second one-time offer. Now, of course, if they only purchase the first one and then they say no thank you, then it stops that sequence, okay? But for the sake of this demo, just so you can understand. So what's the first thing you need to do? Always tag every action that your people are going through. I tell my clients and students, tags are free. What do I mean by that? Even if somebody opts in on a free landing page and they want to get that goodie, you need to tag them, not just that they opted in, but what did they get? What did they sign up for? Because then after the fact, you can segment your list, you can do all kinds of things. So just remember, tags are free, be generous in the taggings. So in this example, they've purchased, so I give them a unique tag that tells me what they purchased. If they purchase the upsell, I give them a second unique tag showing that they purchased that upsell. If they purchase the second upsell, the same thing. They get yet another tag. So this person would have three tags attached to their name. So when I looked at the CRM, I could tell exactly where they came in, what they purchased, and all of that. So now, how do you automate these things so that you can just send out one email that will deliver all the goodies? You need to use what I call the if-then automation. What do I mean by that? And I'm going to show you in real time here. Basically, you build a branch and you have the system look for these tags, and based on whether they find them or not, it will fire off separate emails. So in this example, what we need to figure out is what are the different numbers of scenarios. And in this example, there's three different scenarios. They just purchase and forget the one-time offers, or they purchase plus they get one, the first upsell offer, or the third scenario is they purchase and they get both of the upsells. All right. So are you tracking with me? Is this making sense? So this would be how I would map it out so that I could understand the whole flow. Now, let me hop over to Go High Level and just talk about how would you build out the automations. So the automations always have to start with what we call a trigger. And a trigger just means what fires this off. And in this instance, the trigger is they actually had to purchase that first thing. So you can see over here in my trigger, I'm telling it which funnel, which page, which product, and what's the submission. It is a sale. It is a purchase. Okay. So that is what starts this, that starts the whole ball rolling. All right. Then notice I said it starts adding the tags, and I just realized I need to add tags down here, and I didn't do that. Okay, hold on one second. Okay, I just had to pause for a second. Now here's the caveat that I'm going to talk about. When you are building out more complicated type automations and funnels and all of that kind of stuff, there's usually more than one way to do something. I try to, when I build for clients and I teach my students, I try to keep it as simple as possible, because the more that you add on to something, the more it can break. Okay. And, you know, if somebody's just starting out, is it easier just for you? You know, if you're only getting a couple of sales, it might be easier just for you to manually do some things, but always look at when you're scaling and growing your business. Now, I just realized here, there's a couple of different ways I could handle the upsells. So let me explain how I built this and then just talk about kind of some back end. The main objective, and let me just come back over here. The main objective that this person had when they asked me the question was they only want to send one email. They don't want the person getting hit with three separate emails. Here's the email for the main purchase. Here's the second email for the upsell one. Here's the third. You could do that, but in this instance, they only wanted the one email to go out. So what I would do, just ignore this piece down here for a minute, I would have three different automations based on, and you could add it here also. So we could just go ahead and add another trigger that if they purchased the upsell, it would give them that tag. I probably would just do them in separate automations. Okay. If your eyes are glazing over at this point, that's too much. Don't worry. Join my membership and we can work through this together. All right. So, but the main thing I want to talk about is the if-then condition. So if somebody comes in and they purchase the main thing, they get that purchase tag. And then on the email, if they only have purchased this, okay, and when we open up the if-then conditions, we walk through how we want to build these out. And this one over here is if they do not have the tags, the upsell one and upsell two, then send them this email. And in this email, they would get the link just to the first thing. If this tag here, I should leave this open for a second. If this tag says that, of course, they've got the first purchase tag, but then they also purchase the OTO, then send them that email. And then the middle one here is if the tag has both. And I could have combined these into one. All right. So is that making sense what I'm saying? So as you're building the automations, you're looking at the scenarios and it's just looking and saying, okay, so they've got the purchase tag. That's great. But then what's the next thing? Now it's going to start looking for additional tags. And again, how would I handle those two other tags? The easiest thing is I would duplicate this top part only. So I would have two other little simple automations. And those automations, the only thing they would do is if they purchased upsell one, I would give them upsell one purchase tag. Okay. If they purchased upsell number two, give them upsell purchase number two. I could also add those triggers here also and combine everything. Just depends on how you like to map things out. All right. So let me just come back here and talk to you for a quick second. So as you can see, there's lots of different ways that you can build in these automations. The key is you want to first map the big picture of what you're trying to do and then figure out all the moving pieces. And again, if you're using Gohighlevel, Funnel Gorgeous, or one of these other programs, and you want to join my Digital Business Academy, it's a lower priced monthly membership. And guess what? I am there inside that group every day with you. So when you have questions, I can just open up the hood, so to speak, and help you navigate through. All right. Thanks for watching as always, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.